Meanwhile, an embarrassing mistake by the Department of Transportation, a misspelling and giant block letters right in front of a triad school. Bill O'Neill joins us now live in Greensboro with details. Bill, what's going on?
Hey, Juan, it is a bad day for a local sign painter. It is a very common word, and it happens right outside of a school. Really draw attention to this poor fellow's mishap. Text messages, spelling has become a casualty. But that's private messages between friends. This, on the other hand, is very public and very big.
I thought it was Shaku, and I wasn't really sure who was doing all the spelling for us around here. But we were happy to have the paper, and I will tell you that.
David Moon says it's been years since the state paved Drake Road in southern Guilford County. He says workers did the job last Friday, and he wondered if anyone else would notice the misspelling.
I told my two daughters a while ago, and they hadn't seen it, and they go by here every day for a volleyball practice, and they, after they saw it, they're going to tell everybody they know.
It's hard to miss big block letters painted across two lanes of traffic. A spokesman for the state DOT says, quote, mistakes happen, but adds that state workers didn't do it. The DOT blames a subcontractor named Traffic Markings. I contacted the company, which is located in Graham. The man who answered the phone told me they were going to find someone who could spell and fix the problem ASAP. That's ASAP.
You kind of lose faith in the people that are doing your spelling.
Neighbor David Moon says it definitely wasn't a Southern Guilford High School student.
Not Southern Guilford, honestly. We got a pretty good school down here, good reputation, so we like to keep it that way if we can.
How do you spell school?
S-C-H-O-O-L, not Shakool.
And our friends on Facebook had a good time with the story today. Josh Robertson writes in, not to mention it's right in front of a school. If you didn't know how to spell school, you had help right in front of you. Carrie Boyd says maybe the state should think twice before cutting the educational budget. Sandra Klotvelter Bowles writes, this is so funny, being a person without a spelling gene myself. And finally, Andrea Lester, laughing out loud, says, I'm not even that bad. And I'm pretty bad. Well, those of us who are bad spellers, raise your hand. I'm one of those folks. Wanda, I can't have any fun at this poor fellow's plight today. I did call up that company, Traffic Markings, and the guy said, yeah, they had a little bit of a laugh, too, but they're embarrassed tonight about what had happened.
I'm sure they are. Kind of a big oops. Thanks a lot, Bill.